So let me ask you a question. When was the last time you learned something completely new? I'm interested to know. After the video, leave a comment and share the last time you learned something new and what it was. Now, this channel is focused on tech and development, so naturally, I'm talking about things like a new programming language, a new framework, a new platform, a new pattern, whatever it may be. But this also applies to things outside of programming. What I'm really talking about is the process and the importance of learning. And more importantly, getting over the fear of learning a new thing. Let me start by sharing one bit of knowledge that I picked up on many years ago in this industry. What you know and the skills you have are important, but what's far more important than that is learning how to learn quickly. You know, you probably already know this, but just in case you don't, in the tech industry, the only constant is change. There are very few languages, frameworks, platforms, etc. that are popular now that even existed 20 years ago. And I know, I'm old. 20 years for some of you may be your entire life at this point, but that's kind of my point. How long do you think you'll be working in tech? Most careers of any type last 40 plus years if you start after school and work till your retirement age. During that length of time, you'll likely see many generations of tech come and go. The thing that you're learning right now, and even what you'll learn next, will likely be obsolete by the time you've finished your career. And that's why the most important skill you need as someone in tech is the ability to learn. Learning quickly and adapting to change as tech changes is what gives you the competitive advantage to continue your career until you're old, instead of becoming a relic and getting lapped by the newer generation of kids out of school. So, how do you keep up? How do you learn fast? Well, I think the very first thing is overcoming resistance to change. If you're like me, you probably have an opinion on what's the best programming language and what's the best architecture. This is just human nature. As you continue to grow your skill set, you'll find things you like. And in your opinion, those things you like will be the best. And you know, none of that matters. Seriously, your opinion is great and you should always have a set of pros and cons for everything you like or dislike. But the tech industry swings like a pendulum. And the thing you like today just simply may not be popular tomorrow. So, overcome your preferences. Overcome your fear of the unknown. Learn the stuff you like, and more importantly, learn the stuff that's in demand, even if you don't like it. Even if you only learn it so you know why you don't like it. The second step is honing your ability to learn. Now, I can't tell you exactly how to do this step by step because it's different for everyone, but I can at least give you some pointers on how to get started. Just like everything else in life, practice makes perfect. You need to practice learning quickly and efficiently. So, here's a challenge for you to get started. Go and pick something new you want to learn, but have no idea how it works. If you're a web developer, go make a mobile app. If you're into front-end stuff, go learn a back-end language that isn't JavaScript. And don't cheat and pick something similar to what you already know. Go do something completely different. Doing this will be hard at first, but over time, you'll begin to learn the new skill. But in this case, don't just learn the new skill. Pay careful attention to how you're learning. What is the process you took that helped you learn the thing the fastest? Remember, this isn't an exercise in learning a new thing. It's an exercise in learning how to learn fast. Once you have it ironed out, try to learn a second new thing. But instead of randomly trying different ways to learn, use the same methods you know that worked last time. This is how you learn to learn. And it might be the most important skill you could ever develop as someone in tech. Thanks for stopping by. And until next time, happy coding.